This is Cosmotron, our animatronic cougar, designed by three teams, our mechanical team, software team, and our theater and media arts team.
We've been working together for this animatronic cougar, having all of our pieces come together and so it'll move and look like a real cougar.
Animatronics are big in movies and in theme parks.
Hi.
I learned a lot of things, not just for animatronics, but for prosthetic making, something that could help me with my career. We started figuring out how we're gonna make this robot look like a real animal. A lot of the stuff that we had to learn was about the anatomy of a cougar. We actually went to the Bee Museum. We were asking them if we could look at one of their cougars that they have, and they're like, oh, we have one, you can just borrow it, just take it. We learned how to make flat molds, two-piece molds, three-piece molds. So we learned how to make lots of different kinds of molds for this with lots of different materials.
The mechanical team designed the hardware. Hardware is motors. So we had to make a nose and the eyes, and we had to make eyelids that went on them.
And then we, the software team, we're the ones that give the life to the system and we make the skeleton move. The interface that the puppeteers will be using are two PlayStation 4 DualShock controllers, and these are connected via Bluetooth to a Raspberry Pi computer, and the whole system is powered within the cougar itself.
There are a lot of complex things in the cougar, mostly because it's such a small space. We had to fit everything in this little head, and if it didn't fit in the head, we had to figure out how to connect it from the body up to the head.
So this is our silicon head. It's very squishy. And we had covered it with prosate, which is a kind of glue. And then we had a flocking gun that we added all this fur with. And it uses static electricity to where the hair is only glued at the very end. So it gave it that kind of 3D effect. After we're done flocking it, we added all this detail and dimension and depth to it to make it look like it was a furry cougar face.
The most complex part of this project would definitely be how to make sure everything fits together.
We would 3D print it out, and then they would practice painting on it, and then give it back to us to say, oh, does it still fit?
Player one controller controls the eye movements, the eyebrows, and the ears. And then the other controller can control the jaw with one of the triggers, and it also can move the neck around with the control sticks. These head movements were the most important to create something that could have life and personality in it.
This is really cool, you guys.
This project was really hard, but it was a very good learning opportunity for me.
It makes me feel very validated that my major is more than just lipstick, because that's what a lot of people think it is.
It's really cool. An animatronic cougar, that's something that everyone can be interested in.
It works!